Hi everyone, welcome to another exciting installment of Let's Play Master of Darkness. I'm Simon Belmont, I'm Dr. Ferdinand Social, as played by Duke of the Bump, and we are in the castle, which is part of the cemetery level, or I assume it was supposed to be a cemetery, but the game's not entirely clear about that. I'm not sure why there's a castle here, but that's what we have. This is the first level where we encounter the skeletal warriors. They're slightly tougher than the average enemy. They take two hits with the cane instead of just one. I think one hit with the axe is enough to kill them, but I will stick with the cane, because I am a huge cane enthusiast. See, in the U.S., canes are mostly just associated with the elderly, you know. Usually older gentlemen are the only source to carry canes. But in the U.K., it's regarded as a staple fashion accessory for men of all ages, which I think is pretty cool. Let's see, there's just points in that mass, there's nothing else here worth getting, so I won't waste any time here. Ow. Well, I guess I will waste a little bit of time here since I got knocked down. Okay, that usually doesn't happen. That's strange. So this is where things start becoming a little less linear than the previous levels. I mean, there's still not much exploration involved, but you know, we could have gone up there, but I chose to go right. We'll end up going up eventually, but you know, there's a little bit more to explore over this way. Not really anything worth getting, mostly just a bunch of bats. That's a bottomless pit there, which means if we try to make that jump, that bat is going to knock us to our deaths. So let's draw the bat out. That was just points, and there is a potion over here. It's a risky jump. Ow. It would have been nice if they made sequels to this game that featured a little bit more exploration. You know, like Simon's Quest. You know, that's a great game. It's just entirely too difficult, which made it bad. Well, there are a few things that made it bad, but the difficulty factor is probably the deal breaker for me. You know, they should have continued in the tradition of... Oops, I didn't want the boomerang. Oh well. They should have continued in the tradition of wussifying Castlevania and made, like, a full exploration-style game. That would have been pretty cool. I don't want to go over there. There's nothing worth getting. Just want to jump across these precariously placed bricks. One hit and we start all the way over. And I think this is the end of the level. Yeah. Alright, well, that was productive. I lost a crap load of grenades, but that is okay. And this level is where we first meet the Blue Clan members. Apparently they mixed their robes in with the colors one day, and it stained their immaculate white robes. So they got kicked out of the clan, and now they're stuck here, shooting laser beams out of their swords at psychologists. I guess it's a living. KKK gotta get paid. But they're not in the KKK anymore. This is an interesting mechanic. It's sort of dangerous. A little bit on the precarious side. Damn it, fall. So one up there. We want to wait till that thing comes back over here so we can hitch a ride and not land on those spikes, hopefully. Ideally, that would be the case. Let's see, do I want to get... Nah, forget it. It's not worth it. I don't think it is anyway. Boy, they sure like placing masks directly over spikes, making the items impossible to get without getting hit. Well, not impossible exactly, but, you know. I knew that boomerang would be good for something. It's one of the few places in the game that requires that you get down on your knees and crawl. I mean, sure, you can do it any time, but you don't really have to use that very often. Let's see, I think I'm gonna go down first and then continue to the right. Yeah, there's some stuff down here. Might as well get it. See if I can get him from over here. Nope. The range on this thing sucks. And the damage sucks. Let's see, what do we have here? Just a potion. I probably didn't even need to come down here in the first place. C'est la vie. For those of you who don't speak French, that means fuck it. Ah, this may look like a dead end, but we can jump through that place. The ceiling. Or the floor, depending on your perspective. That jump that I just made was rather dangerous. If you mess that one up, then you plummet to your doom. Oh, and also, I may have neglected to mention this, but this game doesn't really have anything in the way of checkpoints. If you die, generally, you end up having to start the whole level over again. Which, you know, sucks for people who die. Not to toot my own horn, but, you know. And the only way to get back up is to go back down. Unfortunately. Oh yeah, it's good to have grenade power back. I like the bats in this game because they invariably hover for just a second before they start flying. So they're very predictable. Oh, I did not want the sword. Some of these power-ups are, you know, difficult to avoid. Because they place you right next to the mask, and, you know, you either break the mask open and get what's inside, or you miss it. Damn. I think we're coming up close on the boss here. Oh, for God's sake, I hate the sword. And I'm gonna have to fight the boss with the sword and only 5 grenades. Lovely. Just lovely. Okay, you don't want to jump too far here, because if you do, then you'll jump off the edge and you will be dead. Who is this guy? What dark rate? This guy is honestly a lot easier to beat if you have more grenades. I'm not sure how I'm going to do, which is 5. I will try my best. Oh, that got him about halfway down. I'm stuck with freaking sword. Having grenades was really part of my master plan at this point. Well, he's just gonna float there like a moron and let me kill him. That's nice of him. Alright, and at 9:15, I defeated the mysterious red idiot. And he leaps to his doom. Something tells me we haven't seen the last of that guy. Look out, there's some story coming up. Count Masson, of course. Who the hell is Count Masson? The black arts, eh? There's strange doings a-transpiring. Oh, I'm glad Dr. Social understands. And that does it for round 3. Tune in next time for round 4, The Laboratory. I'm Duke of the Bump. See you guys later.